Thank you. name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I will go to the altar of God.
Merciful to me, O Lord, for I cry to you. Oh,
God.
Remember, O Lord, Michael, Edward, Linda, Lima, John, Gladys, Anna, James, and the Fry family, Priscilla, Florine, Lawrence, Marvel, Eric, and the Fickle family, Gloria, Nellie, Henry, Bill, Richard, Joan, Latoya, Danny, and Roger, and all those who suffer any need or adversity, those who sorrow or grieve, those who are sick or hospitalized, those who are in trouble, and those who stand in need of our prayers. Be their sure defense and their help in every need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Let us pray God's healing and protection for Les Anderson, uncle of Michael Anderson, who is recovering from heart surgery.
O Lord, look down. down from heaven. Behold, visit and relieve your servant, bless whom we offer our supplications. Look upon him with the eyes of your mercy. Give him comfort and sure confidence in you. Defend him from the dangers of the enemy, and keep him in perpetual peace and safety. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those newly received into membership in our congregation, especially at Windham Hearing.
Almighty and everlasting God, who makes us both to will and to do those things which are good and acceptable unto your divine majesty, we make our humble supplications unto you for your servant, Edmund, to be received into membership this day. Let your fatherly hand, we beseech you, ever be upon him, and so lead him in the knowledge and obedience of your word, that in the end he may obtain everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray the Lord's blessing on Drusilla Huddleston at the recent anniversary of her birthday.
O Lord, whose mercies are new every morning, and who continually showers your children with your kindness and compassion, grant your continued blessings to Drusilla, that she may number her days aright, and so gain a heart of wisdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those threatened by natural disaster, especially those affected by the hurricanes in Texas, Florida, and the Caribbean, and by the earthquake in Mexico.
Almighty God, merciful Father, your thoughts are not our thoughts, nor your ways our ways. In your wisdom, you have permitted the tragedy in the Caribbean, in Texas, in Florida, especially the Dominican Republic, and in Mexico. We implore you, do not let the hearts of your people despair, nor our faith fail us, but sustain and comfort. Direct all efforts to attend to the injured, console the bereaved, and protect the helpless. Bring hope and healing, that all may find relief and restoration through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Lord, in yours,
hear our prayer.
Let us commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, that we may follow them in godly faith.
In communion with the Church of all times and all places, we commemorate the Blessed Patriarchs, Prophets, Evangelists, Apostles, Confessors, Martyrs, and all your saints, especially Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, the Mother of Jesus Christ, our God and Lord. And although we are undeserving sinners, be pleased to grant us communion and fellowship with those in heaven whose victory we celebrate on earth. Into their company we implore you to admit us, not weighing our merits, but freely pardoning our offenses. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us commend to our Lord all those who have gone before us in faith.
We also pray that you remember all our loved ones who have gone before us with a sign of faith and now sleep the sleep of peace. Grant to these who are resting in Christ as you have promised, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Lord, in your
mercy,
graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. At this time, the congregation may be seated, and we invite Edmund the Baron to come forward to be received as a member of the life. Beloved of the Lord, our Lord Jesus Christ said to his apostles, whoever confesses me before men, I will also confess before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I also will deny before my Father who is in heaven. Lift up your heart, therefore, to the God of all grace, and joyfully give answer to what I now ask you in the name of the Lord. Do you this day, in the presence of God and of this congregation,
Acknowledge the gifts that God gave you in your baptism. If so, answer, yes, I do. Do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways? If so, answer, yes, I renounce them. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit? If so, answer, yes, I believe in God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Do you hold all the prophetic and apostolic scriptures to be the inspired word of God and the doctrine of the Evangelical Lutheran Church drawn from them and confess in the small catechism to be faithful and true? If so, answer, I do. Do you intend to hear the word of God and receive the Lord's Supper faithfully? If so, answer, I do by the grace of God. Do you intend to live according to the word of God and in faith, word, and deed to remain true to God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, even unto death? If so, answer, I do, by the grace of God. You intend to continue steadfast in this confession and church, and to suffer all, even death, rather than fall away from it? If so, answer, I do, by the grace of God. Do you desire to become a member of this congregation? If so, answer, I do. Will you support the work that our gracious Lord has given to this congregation with your prayers and with the gifts that God has given you? If so, answer, I will, with the help of God. Upon this, your confession of faith, I acknowledge publicly that you are a member of Zion Evangelical Lutheran Church of Detroit, Michigan, and of the Evangelical Lutheran Church. Receive the Lord's Supper and participate with us in all the blessings of salvation that your Lord has given to this church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. We stand for prayer. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for your great goodness in bringing this, your Son, to the knowledge of Jesus Christ, his Savior, and enabling him both with the heart to believe and with the mouth to confess his saving name. Grant that by your word and spirit he may continue steadfast in the one true faith, in the fellowship of this congregation, as together we all await the day when those who have fought the good fight of faith shall receive the crown of righteousness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Amen. The congregation may be seated.
waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined to me. He has put a new song in my mouth, praise to our God. Let us pray.
Father of all mercies, accept we beseech you our bodies and souls, our hearts and minds, and all that we are, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice to you. Graciously receive our oblations of praise and thanksgiving, even as you have received your church's worship since the world began. For you have redeemed us to be your own, that we may live unto you with all that we are and all that we have. May our sacrifices of praise be borne by the hand of your holy angel to your altar on high, before the sight of your divine majesty. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
The Lord.
It is truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, who with your only begotten Son and the Holy Ghost are one God, one Lord. In the confession of the only true God, we worship the Trinity in person and the unity in substance of majesty co-equal. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, Holy God, mighty Lord, gracious Father, endless is your mercy and eternal your reign. Send now your Holy Spirit upon us and show this bread and wine to be for us the very body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. A victim pure, a victim holy, a victim immaculate. so that we who partake of them may be filled with every benediction and grace, and being made one with him, may dwell in him even as he dwells in us. You so loved the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Having come into our flesh, he bore our sin in his own body to death, even death on the cross, so that we might live unto righteousness. Therefore, Heavenly Father, with a humble spirit and a contrite heart, we receive in this most holy and blessed sacrament the fruit and benefit of his sacrificial death, which you now graciously bestow upon us through Christ our Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the remission of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Remembering, Holy Father, his life-giving passion and death, his resurrection from the dead, and his glorious ascension into heaven, we celebrate the sacrifice of your Son, our Lord, by means of his Holy Supper. Join our prayers with those of your servants of every time and place, and unite them in the ceaseless petitions of our great high priest, until he comes again in power and great glory, as victorious Lord of all. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Taught by our Lord, and trusting his promise, we are bold to pray. Thank you. we beseech you, from every evil past, present, and to come, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by your compassionate aid we may be ever free from all sin and sheltered from all turmoil, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. The bread that I shall give is my flesh, which I shall give for the life of the world. The Lord be with you. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that this holy sacrament may cleanse and defend us, that we may thereby attain the fulfillment of everlasting salvation. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Almighty God, bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.